Overstay fines can be removed by the Ministry of Immigration in the United Arab Emirates, or you can get a discount and pay very less. In this video, I'll discuss conditions under which overstay fines can be removed from anyone's passport in the United Arab Emirates, or you get a discount, and steps that you need to follow to apply for this discount or to be removed totally without paying anything. In case you're watching for the first time on this channel, I need you to subscribe and click the notification bell. That means every time I have a new video uploaded, you'll be notified. Give this video a thumbs up, and if there's any other topic you want me to discuss, please leave your comment in the comment box. Or if you have any question about this video, you can also leave your comment in the comments box. Big up to all returning subscribers. Thank you so much for your support. Let's now get started on the topic. If you stay in the United Arab Emirates after your visa expires, this means any Emirate, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Ajman, when your visa has expired and you even exceed the grace period that is normally given, the government will impose an overstay fine on your passport. Overstay fines accumulate every day until they are either paid off or you clear them and change your visa status. It should be also noted that you cannot leave the country if you have overstay fines, and you can't even change your visa status if you still have uncleared overstay fines. You will have to clear the overstay fines and either change visa status or you leave the country. However, if you have a valid reason and for conditions or problems beyond your control, then the United Arab Emirates government has a procedure through which they will consider your situation and either approve to remove all the fines or to give a discount and you pay a reduced rate. The GDRFA authority will have to review your application and then either approve or reject your application. GDRFA stands for General Directorate for Residency and Foreign Affairs in the United Arab Emirates. Now let me discuss conditions under which one may qualify and the requirements that you need to present to be considered for review. Number one criteria is the minimum fine should be at least 1,500 if you're on family visa sponsorship, and if your visa is on company sponsorship, then the minimum fine should be at least 3,500 dirhams before you can be considered for this procedure. Second condition is health reasons. If for a serious health problem, you were not able to exit the country on time, for example, if you were bedridden or you are admitted in a hospital during the time when you had to exit, then you can be considered. You can apply for consideration to either approve to remove all the fines, overstay fines, or to give you a discount and you pay maybe 20% or 30%, depending on the review by the GDRFA, and they'll give their recommendation. In this case, you need to present a petition letter from either yourself, your sponsor, or the company. Two, you need to show a medical report from the hospital or from the health center with the dates when you were admitted and the date when you left the hospital. And this letter should be in Arabic. It has to be translated to Arabic. The second condition under which one can be considered for removing overstay fines is if you have been held up in a legal case. Maybe you had a case to follow and you had to go for a hearing in the court, or you were detained by police or any other government authorities. In this case, you qualify to apply for either removing the visa stay fines or to get a discount. In this case, you need to present a petition letter from you, your company, or your sponsor. And secondly, you need to have a letter to whom it may concern from either the court or the police or any other authority that was working with you or the one that you're working with during that time. Fourth condition that will give you a chance to apply for this deduction or removal of your overstay fines is death of either your sponsor or a first line relative. The fifth condition is delay to renew your passport. In case you had sent your passport for renewal and it takes longer than you expected, in this case, the passport returns after your visa expired, then you can apply to remove the overstay fine or to get a discount. There are many cases when you're in the country, your passport expires, you send it back home for renewal. In this case, you may overstay just because the passport is still out, it takes longer than you expected. You will need to submit a petition letter from either you, your sponsor, or the company that you're working for. You also need to attach a letter from the embassy or consulate showing dates when you submitted your passport and when it was returned to you, because you cannot keep it for more days and then go later after a month and claim for deduction or to remove the overstay fines. As we have seen the conditions that qualify you to apply for this, I suggest that you contact someone who has experience, like a travel agent or an attorney, to do the process for you, because you may get a lot of difficulty to do this if you have never done it before. While the travel agents do this most of the time, they can do it with ease. They will just ask you what you have to present that, then they'll help you through the process at a small fee. Even your chances of getting this discount will be higher or removing the overstay. But if you do it yourself, you'll have many challenges and you may fail to present enough proof or miss some documents that will help you to get this approved. Other documents that you need to have: your Emirates ID, your passport, the visa page, copy of the visa page in your passport, Emirates ID of your sponsor and the visa copy of your sponsor, cancellation letter, NOC, and anything that you feel that could be required. But still, I think it's better to use a travel agent or an attorney, because they know better what is required, and it will be easier if you use someone with experience rather than doing it yourself all alone. You may find a lot of challenges and you miss out on this opportunity just because you are not sure what to present and how to present it. For more questions, you can visit any Amir Center and you go to the customer service team. They can help you and tell you and guide you on how to do this if you still want to do it yourself. Thank you. That's it for this video. Watch out for the next video.